this feels strange and untrue, and I won't waste a minute without you.
Good morning. It's nice and early, but we're on the move because it's going to be a windy next couple of days and we want to get settled somewhere more protected than where we are at the moment. Although this is absolutely superb, we are going to get smashed in here. So Michael's just going for a swim at the moment to untie our back line. And once this cute little Turkish fishing boat goes past, we are going to up anchor and get out of here.
To look into mine. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Tell me.
Just getting the bridle off.
Or you're fine. Take my hand, not your fingers,
yep.
Mine, and we'll walk from this dark room for the last time.
Yeah, we do. Halyard's a bit loose. But it'll do for now. We're not going far on this tack.
2.5 miles.
How fast are we going?
6 knots.
That'll do.
Tell me that you open your eyes. Tell me.
That paddleboard's a nice guard for the sail. Saves it rubbing on the lifelines.
Lost a little bit of wind just as we come around. We're doing 6.5, 6.9. We've just lost a little bit of wind now. We're back down to 4.5. But I suspect when we get around this point here, it'll be game on again.
Yeah.
So we're just getting ready for it.
Pete and Di on a Radiance have got their sail out as well. There's just barely enough air, but we're just drifting along quietly.
We need more wind. 3.2 knots.
One thing about the Jenica, hey babe, it's really easy to deploy it, and then if there's not enough wind, we can always just roll it in.
Yeah.
Another couple of knots would be nice.
We're dying.
We are dying. Good morning. Coming to you this morning from this beautiful bay here in a very charming town called Bosmaran. Colourful little place. Oh, it's just a gorgeous day, and because it's such a calm morning, Michael's chosen today to address a problem that's probably been driving you guys almost as mad as it's been driving us, and that is our squeaking wheel at the helm. today Michael's got his mate Peter over because two brains are always better than one when you're pulling something as vital as your helm wheel off your boat and you've never done that before. Let's go and see what the boys are doing and hopefully we can get that steering wheel to finally stop squeaking.
Yes. Yeah, so this is a bearing. Yeah. And this is a rubber seal. There'll be one this end and one on the other side of that bearing.
Yeah.
So that's to stop water again. Like I say, they put these in pumps. So I think it's squeaking around this surface here and this one.
Look at that. And that's the noise.
Just trying to pull this. What's this thing called, guys?
Steering wheel?
No, this. The spindle bit.
Yeah, spindle.
That's what we'll call it. We're just trying to pull this spindle off. Doesn't
like
want to
budge. Steering boss, isn't it?
What's the deal?
Well, we've squeezed some grease in there and literally forced it in both back and front.
Because this is the bearing and this is a rubber seal around this bearing. And it was dry inside there on the inner race and dry on the outer race. So we forced some silicon grease around that. That's cured the squeakiness on that side. We managed to just pull this boss back enough to squeeze some grease, silicon grease in on that lip seal there.
Great.
Makes no noise.
No noise.
All I can hear is the sound of silence.
Yeah.
And the kettle about to boil.
Yeah,
so.
Coffee, mate.
That's a beautiful noise.
That is a beautiful noise. Rightio. That's great, you guys. What is that, silicon?
Yeah, clear silicon.
We're just getting the old silicon off so that we can start again, tidy it up.
So just removing the, we can just put a brand new bead of Sikaflex around there and stop any moisture from getting in there.
This is what's in behind the helm station. Just in case you've ever wondered what's in here.
Great access to all of your instrumentation. Steering wheel chain.
Hello.
Hello. Swanee's playing a couple of hours, so I've got to get this job done.
Yeah, the boys are under pressure.
Yeah.
Kickoff is soon.
I've got a date with the TV.
Steering wheel going back on. Two-person job by the looks.
Absolutely. Try that, Pete. Yeah.
Wake up, arise and shine. Get to work on time.
I'd go up fairly firm on that peak. Yeah, good. Yep. Other one?
So that gear, Pete, that is moving way freer.
It's like velvet now, isn't it? Look at that.
Silk, I would say.
That's never moved like that, guys.
No, that is beautiful.
I'm super impressed. That's one of your best jobs yet, you boys.
Oh, I think that's the best one.
Solar.
Yeah.
Look at it.
Yeah.
There's no resistance on that at all.
No, that's beautiful. We haven't got the chain on yet, but...
Oh, yeah, that's not
bad. The boys have just put the chain back on for the steering, and now we've got to make sure that the helm wheel is actually aligned so that the rudders are straight and the mark on our wheel is still facing north like we've always had it. So we've turned on the instruments and the Garmin will tell us where our rudders are facing at the moment. Well, that's the plan anyway. Over to visit this boat building yard that's, as Pete said, is in the middle of nowhere. Let's go and have a look at it.
Masks.
Oh, bloody masks. God damn it. What's this thing, guys?
The bandsaw.
mind your fingers. Wow. Another bone for the backbone of the boat. That's how you build a boat by hand, guys. Just like that. Oh, the circular.
We admire your work.
Good work. They don't even bother measuring it.
Merhaba.
Merhaba. Yeah, that's close enough.
Right. When you make it 2 years slowly, then you make it good.
Yeah.
And you are a boat builder?
No, I'm the owner. That's my father. This place.
This is your boat?
It's mine, yeah. I hope it's mine.
Wow. Congratulations.
You're a lucky man. Just talk us through how you start to make one of these boats.
Yes, you start with the middle one. You make 6 pieces. Somebody make 8 pieces, right and left side. And then we have the middle. And after that, we make with eye, only with eye, we make these lines. Only on one side.
Yeah.
And when you have it at one side, you make it with this one. And the second one, make the same, yes. It's also like you don't need it because you make space.
Yeah.
He was just saying that they make every one of those wishbones that form up the frame of this boat just by eye. They don't measure it, but look at the continuity of those wishbones. It's absolutely amazing.
Today's a special day then.
Yes, you're right.
This is where they form up their wishbones. So it's all laminated and they glue piece of timber on piece of timber on piece of timber and then bend it into the shape that they want.
And he was saying that they use a white mahogany from Cameroon. It's very strong.
This is your boat?
Yes, I have it here. 14 meters. Yes.
Wow.
So he's cut it in half. He's making it longer. Wow.
Unbelievable.
This timber, all of them?
Yes, all the front, all of them.
It's like watching Noah's Ark being built. All this timber, all this machinery that hasn't probably changed since the Industrial Revolution. So 8 months to cut this boat in half, add 6 meters, is that right? And then put it back together again. My God. Why wouldn't you just buy a bigger boat?
So we're just going for a bit of a tour. This guy in front of me, it's his boat. I think Maria's already said. He's cut it in half and he's adding 16 metres to this thing. Oop, we're going upstairs.
Sort of a bit.
Oh, wow. You got to come up here, Pete.
Watermelon from three fishermen.
Three old salties.
Yeah. It was actually the second watermelon that they gave us. They gave us one the size that Michael's got there. That size. One night. We carried it back Someone Peter carried it back, but he can't remember carrying it back. And then he dropped it.
Something happened to it, didn't it?
Yeah, it all just fell into the bottom of the dinghy.
Well, I thought I'd redesign the dinghy with the inside of it.
Yeah.
With a watermelon interior colour scheme.
The pink floor of our boat next morning, all stuck on.
Had you had something to drink, though?
Yeah, he had a few beers and a few red wines. Michael, you couldn't remember the watermelon either.
Yeah,
it's only me and Marita that could remember what happened.
No, I remember the watermelon instead.
Good morning. We're in this beautiful little bay of what's the name of this place? Dursek. We're in this beautiful little bay of Dursek along the Turkish coast, and we're taking off early this morning because we're going to have a tailwind, which will pick up later in the afternoon. But in the morning, it's supposed to be quite a gentle breeze, and we thought it would be the perfect opportunity to get our new parasailer out today. We haven't put her up yet, so we're pretty excited to get out there and see how she runs on this Elba 45. We normally keep the parasailer in the anchor bay. Normally lives in there, but today she's coming out of the bag.
First time. We haven't even seen the colour.
No, we haven't even unpacked it.
Like it's on here. It looks like a pretty, like a nice green. And we're not going to see the colour until we get the sock up.
Yep.
So we'll get this all set up as much as we can before we leave the anchorage.
Because we're pretty sure that as soon as we turn the corner outside the bay, that we're going to be able to pretty much put it up, aren't we?
So we haven't given her a name yet. We'll have to think of a name.
Yeah. Just setting up the halyard so we can hoist the sail. This is one of the sheets that we run around the outside of the boat, so we've got to make sure that we go around all structures like these stays, around the outside of all of the stanchions, through these little cleats here, and then we're going to use the winch. I think we're going to have to move the pot plant. I'll just get rid of that, love. This is the guys going on around the outside of all of the structures. And underneath the fenders, we've been putting the fenders out lately because there's that many boats in these anchorages and the wind's been a bit crazy in the afternoons. So everyone's been leaving their fenders out on their boats, and we've actually seen quite a few boats rafted up against each other unintentionally. Michael just attaches them to the pelican dodger there. Just while we're getting the sail set up, he just... Michael just attaches them to the pelican striker there. Just while we're preparing, just so that the ends of the lines aren't flapping around. You're on watch for a sec, love. I can't afford his gas, so I'm stuck here watching.
Watching TV.
Got my gloves all ready. Got my shoes on. I'm all ready to fly the kite. And we've got 1.9 knots of wind, which is really disappointing because the wind's actually going to blow up quite a lot this afternoon. And we wanted to get this kite up before the wind really got heavy, you know, 20 knots this afternoon. But I think we're going to be at our destination, babe, before the wind even picks up. So I think we peaked a bit early today.
Happens all the time. We should never ever set that thing up early.
Yeah, when we don't set it
in
up.
In anticipation of getting out here and having, you know, 5, 6 to 10 knots.
I know.
And we get a bag of donuts.
Yeah. So I'm going to have a cup of tea instead because there's no kite flying anytime soon.
9 miles to Ohanye, and it was supposed to be a beautiful parasailer. So we'll have to get that out another day, guys. You're not going to see it today.
No. False alarm. Formations are incredible. What did you say, love?
It's gonna be busy in here.
Oh.
Boats everywhere.
Okay. Try our luck, see if we can find a spot.
Tight little gate. Tight little rope.
Yeah. Mind those shallow patches, love.
I'm guessing if he makes it through, honey, we'll make it through. Inside.
Yeah, true. These guys know every rock and every sandbar.
Nose, so we might motor to the next corner and see what happens, but I think at the next turn it's going to be more on our nose. So it's only a short little hop. We're only doing this little journey to get ourselves a little bit closer to Datcha.
And out of this horrible wind that we've got.
Yeah, Miltempe blowing at the moment out wide down between Turkey and Greece. We're just trying to make our way north in short little hops early in the morning. So we can pop across to Greece as soon as Marita's had her second COVID vaccination. We're out of here.
It's not as easy to pull this sail out as it was with our Lucia, is it?
No, but if you wrapped it, if you wrapped it around the winch a couple of times, you'd find it easier.
Maybe I am crazy too. can rock on.